Food plot architecture is really about diversifying your hunting location. It's about designing a food plot system that attracts deer within bow range. And I really lean on food plot architecture when it comes to having a bigger food plot that's going to have a lot of deer out of bow range, trying to arrange diversity in that food plot to attract deer within bow range. So this is a long, skinny food plot, about 3 to 3.5 acres. You can imagine if we hunt on one end of it, there's a lot of deer that could be out of range. But because we're diversifying the food plot system, adding different crops, we're going to attract deer to spend time at this end of the food plot. And one of the best ways and quickest ways is by planting annual crops and perennial plots or perennial crops. So on this side, in this small little 10th of an acre, we have leaned on perennial clover. So we have clover, red clover, white clover, chicory, and alfalfa here. We've also added some pear trees from Chestnut Hill. We've got a couple late drop pear trees that are going to drop in October and November in a couple of years when they mature. So we go clover, pear trees, step out here, and we're going to see the transition. We have a water hole, but then we transition into annual species, specifically corn, which is a dwarf hybrid corn. We have soybeans, and then we're going to have brassicas and cereal grains underneath. Because it's a food plot in the middle of timber country, the soybeans generally get over browse, so there's enough sunlight to reach the soil that we can spray it to kill off any of the weeds that have grown during the early part of summer and late spring, and then we broadcasted brassicas in July. We'll come back at the latter part of August this week or at the beginning of September when weather is coming, when we have rain coming, and we'll broadcast a mix of cereal grains and winter peas and things like that. So we're gonna have annuals here, perennial behind the camera. We have a water hole. We have a nice screen with switchgrass. We have a blind in place. And the most important part in all this is the access that goes out the back of the food plot. So we never step foot in the food plot. We're always behind the screen. We're always just peeking over a fence, a metaphorical fence, into the food plot and never alerting deer of our presence out here in the plot. So it's a great way to use food plot architecture to try to attract deer within bow range. By that I mean if deer come out down there, because they're diversified foresters, they don't eat just the same crop, there's a good chance that at some point before dark they'll transition here to either get a drink of water, later on eat a pear, or eat perennial clover. So this is the area we're trying to concentrate a lot of movement during daylight hours where we're in range. And this can all be done just by trying to check off boxes, add new things to attract deer to your part of the area. So perennial clover, let's put that in bow range. Annual crops, let's put that in range. Water holes, let's put that in range. Fruit trees, we can put that in range. Mock scrapes, put a couple of them down here. Now we're throwing everything but the kitchen sink to the deer on this end of the food plot. Once you go that way, it's all the same. And we know deer love that, so we've added a lot of acres of that, but we're adding the goodies, really good diverse stuff on this end. And that right there is food plot architecture at its best.